Welcome back. One final point before we go tonight. Conservatives warned a long time ago that the founders of the Women's March were rabidly anti-Semitic and tied to hate preacher Louis Farrakhan. Remember, Louis Farrakhan has called Jews termites, said Jews are evil, blamed Jews for the September 11th, 2001 terror attacks, and called Adolf Hitler a, quote, very great man. Well, now a new report from Tablet Magazine confirms that anti-Semitism and anti-Semitic conspiracy theories that were published in a book written by Louis Farrakhan's Nation of Islam isn't just an undercurrent polluting the Women's March leadership. This anti-Semitism was part of the founding of the Women's March. Go read the Tablet Magazine report for yourself. It's shocking. What's even more shocking is all the Democratic politicians who have praised, participated in, and celebrated the Women's March, yet haven't condemned the anti-Semitism and racism we now know is the foundation of the movement. So here's a list of Democratic politicians who have been part of the Women's March and haven't condemned it. New York Senator Kirsten Gillibrand said, "The Women's March was the most inspiring and transformational moment I've ever witnessed in politics. It happened because four extraordinary women, Tamika Mallory, Bob Bland, Carmen Perez, and Linda Sarsour, had the courage to take on something big." Senator Kamala Harris spoke at the Women's March. Hillary Clinton called the march powerful and thanked them for standing up for our values. Congresswoman Nancy Pelosi spoke at this year's 2018 Women's March. This was after information about the anti-Semitism of the march's leaders was well known. Beto O'Rourke created a Facebook event called Beto Marching with Women in support of the 2018 Dallas Women's March. Senator Bernie Sanders plans to give the keynote speech at the Women's March convention until, ironically, they canceled on him because he is white and male. Senator Elizabeth Warren spoke at the Women's March. Senator Cory Booker claimed the Women's March wasn't partisan. Former Secretary of State John Kerry took to the streets and protested with the Pink Hat Brigade. So did Michael Moore. Senator Amy Klobuchar praised the momentum from the Women's March for helping Democrats stymie GOP healthcare legislation. DNC Chair Tom Perez, remember, he is supposed to be the face of the Democratic Party, he attended the 2018 Women's March. Senator Dianne Feinstein promoted the Women's March on Twitter and told people where to find their local march. Senator Claire McCaskill took selfies of herself in the crowd marching, and so did Senator Tim Kaine. Already forgot about him after 2016, didn't you? Nearly every one of these Democratic politicians has falsely accused Republicans of being racist, bigoted, and hateful. Yet all of these Democrats celebrated, endorsed, or participated in the Women's March, which was founded on anti-Semitism. And none of these Democrats have condemned it. So please join me in calling them out. At this point, if these Democrats don't condemn the Women's March for their anti-Semitism after championing the march and praising it, all of these politicians are enabling hate, bigotry, and anti-Semitism. And that is my final point. You can reach me on Twitter at @Liz_Wheeler. If you liked the show, please send me an email at oann.com/contact. In the meantime, catch us here tomorrow at 9 p.m. Eastern. And until then, have a good night.
Want to see more videos like this? Click on the link below and subscribe to One America News on YouTube, and call your cable provider and kindly demand that One America News is added to your lineup. Call and subscribe today.